Aaron Burnett Out Front, weeknights at 7, only on CNN.
Paris, you know, famous for everything wonderful, people having wine on the street, museums, monuments, restaurants, churches. One of the world's most visited cities with 29 million tourists going there every year. All of this despite the fact that people in Paris do have a reputation for being, shall I say, a bit taciturn. But they are trying to change. Local tourism officials have created a booklet which includes the greetings, spending habits, and customs of people from around the world. And they're giving it to taxi drivers, waiters, hotel managers, and salespeople across the city. They're trying to reform themselves. I mean, you got to give them credit here. And it's not just the French. In 2008, in time for the Beijing Olympics, the Chinese government began a campaign to help its citizens behave better, too. Tried to teach Chinese citizens to refrain from spitting, cutting in line, littering, and clearing throats too loudly so as not to annoy tourists. It was an effective idea. Recently, one of our producers, a Chinese American, was in China, and a woman apologized for cutting in line, saying, "I need to mind my manners." So it seemed it was working. Maybe it's time the USA copied France and China, because as much as these programs say about the behavior of the host nations, they speak volumes about the guests. According to the Paris Handbook, the four things American tourists are in need of are quick service, constant attention, reassurance when it comes to price, and fluency in English. Basically, the United States, us Americans are impatient, needy, cheap, and unwilling to learn another language. And you think the French are rude? As important as it is to be a good host, it is equally important to be a good guest, which is something for us all to remember as we head on vacation or welcome visitors, including los French, here at home.